continue here the derivation part, the microwave transmission lines. So here the wavelength. The wavelength, already we know that wavelength is denoted by the letter lambda. Wavelength lambda, which is defined as the distance traveled by the wave in order to undergo a phase shift of 2 pi radians, is related to the phase constant beta. So wavelength can be written as 2 pi by beta. So is equal to 2 pi. Already we derived this equation, phase constant, that is omega into square root of root LC. So 2 pi divided by omega can be replaced by 2 pi f into square root of LC. So 2 pi will get cancelled. So lambda equations will be lambda is equal to 1 by f root LC, where f is frequency of the wave. Similarly, velocity of wave propagation denoted by v suffix t, the rate at which the wavelength changes its phase in terms of wavelength lambda, is defined as the phase velocity vp. So here you can see here vp is equal to lambda by t. So I'll write lambda as such only, 1 by t can be represented by frequency. So in this, for this equation, I'll divide numerator and denominator, divide and multiply by 2 pi. So here the term will have lambda into 2 pi f, I'll take it as term, numerator term divided by 2 pi. So Vp is equal to 2 pi f, and whatever the numerator lambda is there, that lambda I'll take into denominator. Therefore Vp is equal to, new 2 pi f is nothing but omega, and 2 pi by lambda is nothing but beta. And this is equal to omega divided by beta is propagation constant. We already know that omega into root LC. So Vp is equal to 1 by root LC, that is velocity of wave propagation. For air cored conductor, the phase velocity Vp will be approximately equal to velocity of light in free space. Vp is equal to 1 by root LC is equal to 1 by square root of mu naught and epsilon naught. We already know that mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7, and epsilon naught is 10 to the power of minus 9 divided by 36 pi. So velocity of propagation will be 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So if the microwave transmission line contains a dielectric having dielectric constant epsilon r and relative permeability mu r, then the phase velocity will be smaller than that through the air is given by Vp epsilon is equal to square root of 1 by square root of mu epsilon. So 1 by square root of mu naught into mu r and epsilon naught into epsilon r equals C divided by epsilon r into epsilon mu r into epsilon r. Since 1 by square root of mu naught into epsilon can be written as C, therefore C divided by square root of mu r divided by epsilon r. The relative phase velocity factor Vr is defined as Vr is equal to actual phase velocity divided by velocity of light in free space. So actual phase velocity is V epsilon divided by C. In the substitute the value of both the things, I'll get the answer as 1 divided by square root of mu r epsilon r. Computation of primary constant. So here the primary constant what we are using in the transmission lines are R, L, G and C. So we have how to find out this R, L and G in the problems. For this we are having some steps. Knowing the secondary constant Z naught and gamma and F of the wave propagating to the transmission line, the primary constant R, L, G and C can be obtained. Already I explained that Z naught is called as characteristic impedance and gamma is propagation constant. Z naught value is square root of Z by Y and gamma is square root of Z into Y. And we already know that Z is R plus J omega L and one more term Y is G plus J omega C. Both the values I am substituting here. So gamma will be R plus J omega square root of R plus J omega L into G plus J omega C, and Z naught is equal to square root of alpha plus J omega L divided by G plus J omega C. So multiplying both the terms, gamma into Z naught, if you multiply both the terms, G of J omega C and G of J omega C will get cancelled. So remaining term is R plus J omega L, and dividing both, that is gamma by Z naught, R plus J omega L term will get cancelled. So the remaining term is G plus J omega C. One more concept here is input impedance of microwave transmission lines. Let us consider a microwave transmission line of length L terminated in a load impedance of ZL as shown in the figure. So we can see in the figure, already I told in the transmission line will have sending end and the receiving end. So in this we are taking sending end and here the load end, that is load end we are connecting here. Load impedance, across this load impedance current flowing is IL and the voltage across this load impedance is VL. So this is a microwave transmission line of length L. Length L terminated in ZL. So you can see length L marked in the diagram. So expression for the voltage and the current at any point in the transmission line. Now just we know we did have that V of Z is equal to VL cos H cos hyperbolic gamma Z plus IL Z naught sin hyperbolic gamma Z and IZ is IL divided IL into cos H gamma Z plus VL by Z naught sin H gamma Z. So already we know that input impedance of the line of length L is given by, so impedance is nothing but voltage by current, but terminated by input impedance the line of length L we are going to find. So we need to replace Z by L. So VL is into cos H gamma L plus IL Z naught sin H gamma L divided by IL cos H gamma L plus VL by Z naught sin H gamma L. So, but in the diagram, we can see that voltage across the load is equal to IL into ZL. So, in the above equation, ZS is equal to IL ZL cos H omega L gamma L plus IL Z0 sin H gamma L divided by IL cos H gamma L plus IL ZL by Z0 sin H gamma L. So, ZS is equal to ZL cos H gamma L plus Z0 sin H gamma L. And cos H gamma L plus ZL by Z0 sin H gamma L, because in both numerator and denominator IL I have taken common and numerator IL and denominator IL will be gets cancels. So now ZS is equal to, and I will take this Z0 outside, take denominator I will take Z0 as LCM and I will take to numerator. So we can write it here Z0 as ZL cos H gamma L plus Z0 sin H gamma L divided by Z0 cos H gamma L plus ZL sin H gamma L. So when a microwave transmission line is terminated in its characteristic impedance Z0, so if it is terminated by characteristic Z0, then ZL term should be replaced by Z0. So if I substitute here ZL is equal to Z0 in the above equation, so in the equation you can see if you substitute in the place of ZL Z0, numerator term and denominator term will get cancelled and finally I'll get only ZS is equal to Z0. That is, when the line is terminated in Z0, then the input impedance of that line is equal to the characteristic impedance Z0 irrespective of the length of transmission line. So now we'll consider V of Z. This already we have derived this equation, same equation we are using here. 1 by 2 V IL plus IL Z0 e to the power of gamma Z plus 1 by 2 VL minus IL Z0 e to the power of minus gamma Z. So here I'll take VL as common. So 1 plus IL Z0 by VL e to the power of gamma Z. Here also plus VL by 2 1 minus IL Z0 by IL. So V of Z is equal to VL by 2 1 plus. So here we are, you can see in the equation IL by VL. So we'll take it as ZL. So Z0 by ZL e to the power of gamma Z plus 1 minus Z0 by ZL e to the power of minus gamma Z. So V of Z is equal to VL by Z0. We'll take it as common. We'll take the LCM, that is ZL plus Z0 by ZL e to the power of gamma Z plus ZL minus Z0 by ZL e to the power of minus gamma Z. In both the equations, we can see denominator term is ZL is common. So that also we'll take it as outside. So VL by 2 ZL, ZL plus Z0 e to the power of gamma Z plus ZL minus Z0 e to the power of minus gamma Z. So VZ is equal to VL divided by, we'll take this also common, ZL plus Z0 by ZL. E to the power of first term is e to the power of gamma Z plus second term is ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0 e to the power of minus gamma Z. So similarly, see, considering current equation I of the derivative, we'll get IL by 2 ZL plus Z0 by Z0 e to the power of gamma Z minus ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0 into e to the power of minus gamma Z.